Hello there. It's brilliant that you're here watching this video. It shows that you showed up for yourself and you want to focus on the things that aren't quite working in your life and make improvements. You're really valuing your life and your happiness and your relationships. So that's fantastic. Today, I'm going to be looking at those really difficult relationship problems that happen in groups. Often in families, sometimes in groups of friends. And you know, those situations where you just keep having these same old arguments all the time, the same sort of patterns keep playing out. And it's really draining, really frustrating. And things seem to be okay for a while, and then they go back to that same old pattern again. If this is you, the chances are that you're caught up in what we call a drama triangle. We all get caught up in drama triangles from time to time. The trick is to recognize that we're in one so that we can step out of it. And that way we break the cycle of all these difficulties and these conflicts and confrontations that keep happening. So let me first tell you about a drama triangle so that you can understand how that works. And I'm sure you'll recognize that maybe you're in one right now or you have been in the past. They tend to happen, as I say, in groups of people, often in families, sometimes in those sort of friendships where there's a group of friends that you all know each other and you kind of interact with each other, and there's these tensions and these conflicts. And actually, they can happen between people, but they can also happen if you find yourself in a situation, say you break away from family or from friends, and you have new people in your life. And that becomes a group. And then you find you're having the same problems again. That's because you've got back into the drama triangle. So the drama triangle isn't so much about the people, it's about the interactions and the patterns that happen between people. And what we get used to being in these roles and we just replay them over and over. So as a triangle suggests, there's three points, and therefore there's three roles that we can play. Quite often, we can see this easily if it's a group of three, but actually, drama triangles can happen in larger groups where these three roles keep being interchanged and being played out. They can also happen with two people. So you can have a drama triangle with two people because it's about the roles, the three different roles that keep being played out between them. But for the example I want to give you today to help explain drama triangles, I'm going to kind of give it in an example of three people so that it makes it a little bit easier to understand. And then you can think about that and how that applies to your life, and maybe with one other person, with two other people, or with a whole group of people. So with a triangle, we have these three points, and each of those points represents a role that we take on. Those roles are the persecutor, the victim, and the rescuer. Sometimes we get comfortable in one of those roles or a couple of those roles, and we tend to go into those more. Quite often, what happens is that we shift around. So, three people can be persecutor, rescuer, or victim, moving around all the time from one to the other. It happens because you are in the triangle together, in that sort of role shift together. So the persecutor role is when you're cross, you're putting other people down, you're being critical, or somebody's behaving like that to you. That's the persecutor role. Then the victim role is when we feel victimized, we feel got at, we feel that somebody's had a go at us, or they've been mean to us, or they've treated us badly, and we kind of move into that sort of victim place. We feel that they've put us in the victim place. So that's not always the case, but that's what it feels like. And then the rescuer role is when we feel the need to go and rescue somebody, or we want to step in, or maybe they're kind of asking us to rescue them. So if I give you an example of, say, let's say there were, say, three sisters. It could be parents and a grown-up child, parents and child. It could be uncles, aunties, friends. It could be anybody, really. But let's say three sisters, just to make this clear. So let's call them Mary, Jane, and Elizabeth. Easy names. So Mary's cross, and she has a go at Jane. So Mary's in the persecutor role, Jane is in the victim role. Jane turns around to Elizabeth and says, "Oh, you know, Mary's been horrible to me. Rescue me, be on my side." So Elizabeth goes to Mary and she says, "Why did you have a go at Jane?" And Mary says, "Oh, why are you having a go at me?" So there you see Elizabeth has moved into the persecutor role and Mary's turned into the victim role. And so it goes on like this, and we go round and round and round, moving, shifting back and forth, taking sides, being the persecutor, being the victim, being the rescuer. Maybe, you know, Jane might say, "Well, I'm cross with everybody for having a go at me." And so she becomes the persecutor. And then Mary might turn to Elizabeth and say, "Jane's having a go at me. Please rescue me." Can you see how that happens? And I'm sure you'll recognize it either for something that a situation with people in your life right now, or perhaps you've been there. We pretty much all of us go into these drama triangles from time to time. Sometimes we get stuck in them. So the trick is to step out of the triangle. If you think about people doing a dance, like in a sequence, if one person changes the steps, if they come out of that dance or they change the steps, well, the other two, they can't actually be in sequence anymore, can they? And it's like that with the drama triangle. If you recognize the roles that you're playing and you step out of that, then the other people who are playing a drama triangle roles, they have nowhere to go with that, where you're concerned. So let's have a look at that. If somebody is in the persecutor role, a way to look at that to step out of it is first of all to recognize it and make an intention not to do it. If you feel like you keep getting back into it, the way to step out of that then is to say, well, let's look at it from a different perspective. The persecutor often simply feels out of control. They feel that the control they have has been taken away from them. They're frustrated, they're angry, things aren't going right, and they really just need to regain control. If somebody's being persecuting towards you, recognizing that can go a long way to helping you to feel less of a victim, to helping you feel less disempowered, because you recognize that that's what's going on for them. It doesn't make it all right for them to be bossy and critical of you and bully you at all. That's not what I'm saying. But what I'm saying is by recognizing that they're coming from that place of stress and anxiety and feeling out of control, you can sort of step back a bit and say, well, that's nothing to do with me. That's their stuff. If it's you that keeps going into the angry persecutor role, think about that for a while and think about, well, what is this control and what can I do about that to help myself? From the victim role perspective, it's really useful again to recognize when you're in the victim role and make a decision and intention to step out of it. If you're finding that difficult, it's good to look at it from the perspective of, well, am I actually a victim or am I just feeling vulnerable? Because maybe somebody's been the persecutor towards me and I don't like it, it's uncomfortable. Of course it is. But actually, if we think about that, we think, well, yeah, I don't like this feeling. I feel vulnerable. I don't want to choose to be a victim, but I am going to allow myself to say, yeah, I feel that hurts. That's not nice being on the receiving end of that. And I feel very vulnerable. But I'm not going to stay in this dynamic, you know, this sort of interaction with this persecutor person. I'm going to have a relationship with myself here. I'm going to focus on less about being a victim to them and more about me being a feeling vulnerable and what can I do? What self-love can I give to myself? How can I soothe myself? How can I be kind to myself? And how can I nurture myself in this way while I'm feeling vulnerable? And that goes a very long way to making you feel much more empowered. And actually, it takes you away from that interaction with the persecutor. So they've nowhere to go with that. And then, of course, there's the rescuer. If you find yourself in the rescuer role, it's important to think, well, you know, do I want to rescue this person? Because in the long run, it's probably not going to help any of us because we're just going round and round in Well, I won't say circles, triangles here. We're going round and round in these roles, all of us. But actually, I would like to help this person. So rather than rescuing them and kind of siding with them and, staying in the game, what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of think of ways that I can support them. And if you've been watching some of my other videos or you read my books, you know that I often talk about the difference between rescuing and supporting somebody. Rescuing somebody is jumping in and doing it all for them and defending them and really not giving them a chance to feel empowered because you're doing it for them. Supporting somebody is encouraging them to help themselves, being by their side, being with them, but not actually doing it for them. So if you find yourself in a drama triangle and you get pulled into being the rescuer, either you feel compelled to rescue or somebody keeps, the other people in this group are kind of asking you to side with them and rescue them. Think about, well, how can I support them instead? You can do that by asking them empowering questions about what they can do to help themselves and giving them lots of validation and lots of encouragement that they can do this. And so, as you can see from the roles of the persecutor, the victim, and the rescuer, if we recognize that that's what's going on for ourselves and the people around us, and we choose to step back out of that and see it from a different perspective, view those roles from a different perspective and approach them from that different perspective, then we can break these cycles and those arguments and those conflicts and all that confrontation and that bad feeling, game playing and people feeling bad all the time, that just falls away. So if you relate to this, I'd love to hear from you in the comments. Maybe you recognize yourself as being in a drama triangle right now, or that you have been in the past. Maybe you have taken note of the things that I've been saying here and you recognize, well, maybe I could make some changes if I take this new approach. If you like the video, please do hit the thumbs up like button. It means more people get to see the video. That way I can help them. You can support me in helping them. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button so you'll know when I have other videos coming out. It's been great to spend some time with you today in time and space. I always think that we're together no matter where we are in the world or what time it is for each of us. We're connected now. I'm sending you all my love, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye-bye for now.